Until recently, a Simbang Gabi program like this couldn't be found in Utah. But thanks to the state's Filipino Catholic community, including its first and only Pinoy priest, local kababayans can now experience this centuries-old Philippine Christmas custom.
Oftentimes we feel nostalgic of the celebration in the Philippines, so we decided we need to reach the Filipinos.
While Simbang Gabi has been held in the Philippines since the 16th century, it arrived in Utah just 6 years ago.
It helped us prepare for church and Christmas and the Lord's birthday.
Each of the 9 masses that compose the celebration is held at a different location, including remote parts of the state.
We go as far as Logan. We've been to Logan, which is the border of Utah and Idaho. So instead of concentrating in one parish, we go out to different parishes to reach out the Filipinos.
Although it's a Catholic tradition, the Simbang Gabi in Utah also attracts members of other faiths, particularly Filipino Mormons.
They want to participate and they want to see and they want to share the culture and see the culture.
An important part of the Simbang Gabi tradition is the parol. The star-shaped lantern represents various ideas and messages, including the hope and goodwill of Filipinos during the Christmas season.
And in the Philippine tradition, it symbolizes the people would use to light up their way in going to the early dawn masses.
In addition to helping people get spiritually prepared for Christmas, organizers hope Simbang Gabi will also educate second-generation Filipinos about their heritage.
If we don't do the tradition here, imagine what's going to happen with the children. Just the fact that they're Americanized and they can easily follow the culture of America.
They say it'll be up to the youth of the church to continue to grow the age-old custom in Utah. Jared Bray, ABS-CBN News.